Hello, friend. This is James Hodge and the Believers Quartet, and we're just want you to know how much we appreciate WLJC. We appreciate the ministry and Sister Margaret. We appreciate the program, The Hour of Harvest, and we have many folks that tell us as we go along through our daily lives that they're encouraged by this program, that they watch Sister Margaret every night, and we're thankful for that, and we're thankful that there are souls being saved through this station, and we ask you just to support this station and give as you can and pray for them. Pray for the ministry that they have here. And we just want to let you know how much we appreciate you and appreciate you tuning in to this station. And God bless you.
Good evening and welcome to the service tonight. We trust you will be able to stay with us because we have some good singing coming up. Dottie has phone operators up there and we're going to do our best to help you to get your mind on the Lord and off of all of our troubles and our trials of today and just worship the Lord. Get our mind on Him and enjoy His presence and His love for us. We welcome each of you, regardless of where you have joined us from. We have some great news to start out with. Last night, as we started to go off the air, there was a lady from Nicholasville called and accepted the Lord as her personal Savior, and we did not have time to put it on the air, so we're reporting it right now. That's a salvation report. And also we have two more folk that were saved today and at the hospice center. There was two of them that accepted the Lord. All right. And then we have a special friend, a little AJ from Rockcastle, and he loves us all. And so he'll be watching tonight. So we want the program to bless AJ and all of his little friends at this home that they are in. Well, we have some good news, and that's the Bible. We always want to share that with you. Someone asked me the other day, what was my favorite verse in the Bible? And I said, well, if I had to just choose one, it would be John 3:16. So that's where we're going to tonight, is John, the third chapter, starting with the 15th verse. And whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the condemnation, that light come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest their deeds should be reproved. But he that doeth truth cometh to the light, but that his deeds may be made manifest, that they are wrought in God. John 3, 15 through 21. And so that is the heart of the gospel, John 3, 16. And that is that God so loved the world, and that means everyone, the good, the bad, the ugly, and the unfortunate, the ones that are rich, the ones that are poor, everybody in the world. That means every individual in the world. He loved so much, so much. You know, we cannot really comprehend how much he really loved us, but that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And that's what we want to do, is to tell people about heaven. And if they make that choice, how happy they will be, and there will be consequences if they do not make that choice and neglect the Lord in their life. Well, we want to pray for everyone now, and we have a email in here for a son that's been on drugs so bad he's been clean for 10 days and needs all the prayer warriors to pray hard for my son. I don't want to lose him to this evil. He is only 19 years old. Please pray for him. And so we know other teenagers that are really in a rebellious, self-destructive mode right now, and they need deliverance. They need the Lord in their life. He's the only one that really can shake them up and turn them around and change that evil that's in their heart. And so that's what we must pray for the Lord to deliver them. If you have a prayer request, be sure and call it in, and we will share it with the people, and they'll pray upstairs already when you call in, if that's what you like. All right, let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, how we thank you for your goodness. How we thank you for that great love you had for us. And we do pray that you'll help us to each be able to understand and appreciate it more than ever before. And so tonight, Lord, help everyone that is not saved, that is not accepted Jesus as their personal Savior. Help them to make that all-important decision tonight. Bless our guests and our phone operators and those that will be calling, and especially our young people, Lord, throughout the land. Deliver them from the hand of the enemy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, tonight we have, as our singing guest, we have Lonnie King from Ferguson, Kentucky, and he does have CDs for sale. The phone number is 606-679-8579, and so you be sure and call and order, and I'm sure there'll be probably has more, but a lot of these songs he has written, I believe, and he can tell you all about it when you call. All right, let's welcome Lonnie King.
Hello everybody, and thanks for having me in your living room or wherever you may be watching from tonight. My name's Lonnie King, and I'm a singer-songwriter from Ferguson, Kentucky, and I have my family here with me tonight. You'll see them here in a few minutes, and they're going to get up and do two or three songs for you. And I'm going to do some songs off of my three albums. This first one is entitled God's Gated Neighborhood.
Well, I used to try to keep up with the Joneses down the street, and it seemed like for a little while we had one of everything. We were building up our earthly homes filled with all the thrills, when we should have been working on a mansion on the hill. There won't be no U-Haul trailers pulling through the pearly gates. All the treasures we've laid up on earth won't be worth a thing. All the money we put in the bank won't do us no good. No, there won't be no upper class in God's gated neighborhood. No, they won't. No, you won't find a hardware store up in Beulah, 'cause all the homes made in heaven weren't made by human hands. No, you won't find a Kroger or Super Walmart store. Everything will be provided, we won't need them anymore. There won't be no U-Haul trailers pulling through the pearly gates. All the treasures we've laid up on earth won't be worth a thing. All all the money we put in the bank won't do us no good. No, there won't be no upper class in God's gated neighborhood. No, there won't be no U-Haul trailers pulling through the pearly gates. All the treasures we've laid up on earth won't be worth a thing. And all the money we put in the bank won't do us no good. No, there won't be no upper class in God's gated neighborhood. No, there won't be no upper class in God's gated neighborhood.
Thank y'all. Oh, that's my kids over there, if you hear any hollering and carrying on. All right. I'm going to do one for you entitled My Name's in the Book. I'm going to do this one for Charlotte Johnson. She's sitting at home watching tonight. This one's for you, Mom. Can't take them anywhere.
Met an old friend today. The years have took their toll. We talked about the years gone by and all the friends we used to know. He said, I've turned my life around. Oh, but look how long it's took. As you turned to walk away, you said, my name's in the book. My name's in the book. The address is still the same. I still live by the church where our families always pray. I still fish in water that washed our sins away. All you have to do is look. My name's in the book. As he turned to walk away, he said, you know we'll meet again. It might be here in this old world, or it might be Beulah Land. If I am the first to go, I'll be standing by the brook. As he turned to walk away, he said, my name's in the book. My name's in the book. The address is still the same. I still live by the church where our families always pray. I still fish in the water that washed our sins away. All you have to do is look. My name's in the book. As he laid up there all still and quiet, I couldn't. Remember the last words that my friend said to me. My name's in the book. The address is still the same. I still live by the church where our families always pray. I still fish in the water that washed our sins away. All you have to do is look. My name's in the book. All you have to do is look. My name's in the book. How about you, my friend? Is your name in the book?
Thank you. Well, I'd like to send this one out to my new church family. We joined First Baptist in Somerset, Kentucky, and this is for all you fine people that we've met and that we're getting to know out there in Somerset. So this one's for you. Was that you, Lord? Thing I remember was fighting that steering wheel, lying there in pain, broken glass and twisted steel. Someone took me by the hand and said, we're going to make it through. I could hear the thunder, I could feel the rain, not knowing if my life would ever be the same. Then a peaceful, easy feel started coming over me. Was that you, Lord, when I lost all hope? Was that you, Lord, who walked with me that road? Was that you, Lord, knocking at my door? Was that you, Lord, when I needed healing power? Was that you, Lord, there in my darkest hour? Was that you, Lord? Was that you, lying there in that bed? I don't know if he was really there or if he was in my head, but he looked a lot like Jesus. You know, I said the sinner's prayer right then and there. Was that you, Lord, when I lost all hope? Was that you, Lord, who walked with me that road? Was that you, Lord, knocking at my door? Was that you, Lord, when I needed healing power? Was that you, Lord, there in my darkest hour? Was that you, Lord? Was that you? Was that you? Was that you, Lord? Was that you, Lord? Was that you? Was that you, Lord? Was that you, Lord? Was that you? Was that you? Thank you all. Here's one that I'd like to do for my family from Pineville. We just had the family reunion over there, and believe it or not, one of my sons met his future fiance at the family reunion. But it's not as bad as you sound, folks. Not as bad as it sounds. They're both adopted, and they're both from different families, so everything is good. But they're planning on getting married in, around December, somewhere from December to May or June or something like that. But anyway, congratulations to, what is your name? Oh, Jacob King. And his fiance is Kayla Cinnamon. So I'm gonna do this one for you all. It's called Forever in the End.
And a Barlow knife, an old school desk, and a zest for life. They carved their names deep in the grain and wrote love in the middle, and forever in the end. Two young lovers in an old pine tree, deep in the woods where no one could see. They carved their names deep in the grain and wrote love in the middle, and forever in the end. He was captain of the football team, and she was crowned homecoming queen in the yearbook back in 53. They were voting most likely to be a young married couple with a fresh sidewalk, led to the house that they just bought. They took a stick and they scratched in their name, wrote love in the middle, and forever in the end. Now their names are carved in stone. The good Lord finally called them home, but it seemed like only yesterday. They used to laugh and they used to play. And they were two kids and a Barlow knife, an old school desk and a zest for life. They carved their names deep in the grain and wrote love in the middle, and forever in the end. Forever in the end. Forever in.
Well, thank you. For those of you that know us, me and Margaret, we have adopted quite a few children, and we were into foster parenting for a while. And we were married, I think, 13 years, Margaret? Or 14? 14 years, and, for one reason or another, we couldn't have children, and we prayed about it 1 month, and then the next month, the opportunity came to adopt our oldest boy, Josh, who's 19 now, going to UK and all that, and we were really, really blessed, the blessings have been coming since then, so we've adopted 10, they're just such blessings to us. And we did a video called For Pete's Sake. You can go on YouTube and find this video. Just type in Lonnie King or For Pete's Sake, or go on LonnieKing.com, and you can find all these videos. We also did one on Long Black Train, but that's another story. But I'm going to do this song here for you. It's one that we did a video on, and it's one that we got some radio airplay on for several weeks in Somerset, Kentucky. Our good buddy Rod Bubba played it for us. And so give it a listen. Mm-hmm.
looked out the window as the car drove away, not really understanding what had taken place. He could see his mother crying as they were leading her away. Life as he knew it ended on that day. For Pete's sake, he needs a better place. He needs a father, he needs a mother to count on day to day. For Pete's sake, he needs a touch of grace, someone to hold him, someone to love him, and to chase his fears away. Chase his fears away, for Pete's sake. I overheard some talking about how it was such a waste. They had a little boy with problems that needed to be placed. They said he'd led a hard life, and you could see it on his face. 8 years of knowing too much, man, he could use a break. For Pete's sake, he needs a better place. He needs a father, he needs a mother to count on from day to day. For Pete's sake, a touch of grace, someone to hold him, someone to love him, and to chase his fears away, chase his fears away. He needs somebody to open up their hearts. Could you be that someone to give him a brand new start? For Pete's sake, he needs a better place. He needs a father, he needs a mother to count on from day to day. For Pete's sake, he needs a touch of grace, someone to hold him, someone to love him. For Pete's sake.
I get all choked up.
Oh, for Pete's sake.
Thank you. Yeah, if you were interested in becoming a foster or adoptive parent, all you got to do is just contact your local DCBS office, and they'll be glad to direct you on what you need to do to get started. All right, this next song is one I was actually over in Don's neck of the woods, Manchester, when I was a young boy, and I remember this. I remember this gentleman, he'd get this box out, soapbox, and he'd get up and he'd go to the corner and he'd just preach up a storm. And I don't know if you remember him or not, Don, but I guess I was in kindergarten whenever he was doing that. But that inspired this song. It's entitled Pray Hard and Live Right.
Box. He said the end is coming and it can't be stopped. He said all you sinners better get in line and lift your hands toward heaven, it's repenting time. live right. You need to pray hard. He said, if you're not saved, you'll go to hell for sure. But if you repent, you're gonna be just fine. You know, as long as you're breathing, brother, there's still time. You need to pray hard, live right, profess your faith that Jesus Christ. Time to dedicate your life, and all God's children need to stay in school. Go to church on Sunday, obey God's rule. If you want to wake up to those heavenly lights, you need to pray hard, live right. You need to pray hard, live right. You need to pray hard. Live right. Somebody say amen. Thank y'all. All right. Is it all right if I make an announcement about an event I'm having Saturday with Sister Margaret? We're having an event at the Bronston RV Park Saturday. It's going to be a group that I play with, the Fall Creek Boys, and several other groups are coming in, and we're just going to spend the whole day just enjoying the Christian music and the fellowship, and you know. So I won't talk a long time on it, but you can get on fallcreekboys.com, and there's all kinds of information on it there. And thanks for letting me say that. All right, I'm gonna do a song here that I didn't write, and a gentleman, Ralph Stanley, actually wrote this song, and we got to do a Ralph Stanley pre-show, I guess about 5 weeks ago in Somerset, and awesome man, and you know, his whole family are just awesome, and but anyway, he wrote this song, Josh Turner. Sung it, and he sung a verse on it with Josh. It's called Me and God. There ain't nothing that we can't do, me and God. There ain't no one to come between me and someday we're gonna live where the angels trod, me and God. Early in the morning, talking it over, me and God. Late at night, talking it over, me and God. I guess you'd say we're like two peas in a pod. God. He's my father, he's my friend, the beginning and the end. He rules the world with the staff and the rod. We're a team, me and God. I am weak, but He is strong. Me and God, He forgives me when I'm wrong. Me and God, He's the one I lean on when life gets hard. Me and God, He's my Father, He's my friend, the beginning and the end. He rules the world with a staff and rod with a team. And God, He rules the world with a staff and rod. We're a team. Me and God, yeah, we're a team. Me and God.
Thank y'all. Here's I mentioned a while ago that I'd done a video on Long Black Train, and I've had several requests to do this song when I come over here. I'm going to do this one for my friends Almer and Betty and Abnett and Billy K. Smith. This song is for you, and thanks for all your kind comments. If you'll go to YouTube, you can check out this video, or go to LonnieKing.com and you can see it there also. It's got 70,000 hits, praise the Lord. All right, it's entitled Long Black Train.
There's a long black train beating off souls that are lost and dying. Rails of sin, only evil remains. You better watch out, brother, for that long black train. Look to the heavens, you can look to the sky. You can find redemption right back in your eyes. There is protection and there's peace the same. Burn in your ticket for that long black train. You know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father holy name, but don't go riding on that long black train. There's an engineer on that long black train, making you wonder if the ride's worth the pain. He's waiting there for your heart to say, let me ride on that long black train. You know there's victory in the Lord, I say. Victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and His holy name. But don't go riding on that long. From a mile away, and it sounds so good but I must stay away. And that train is a beauty, making everybody stare, but its only destination is the middle of nowhere. You know there's victory in the Lord, I say, victory in the Lord. Cling to the Father and His holy name, but don't go riding on that long black train. I say cling to the Father and His holy name, but don't go riding on that long black train. You better watch out, brother, for that long black train. There's a devil driver that long black train.
All right. I'm going to do one for you that sort of started the first song that I ever wrote and recorded, having to do with country gospel music. I was riding from a church event one night, and the Lord just sort of dropped this song on me all at once. It's called Dead End Road. I went searching for those streets of gold, looking for salvation and the holy word. I was down on my luck, nowhere ready to go. I guess I was headed down a dead end road. Then I went walking in no particular direction. I was getting close to the end of life's road, just about to give up on ever finding redemption, till I found a little church down a dead end road. I found Jesus down a dead end road. I can feel Him with me now wherever I go. A change came over me, it uplifted my soul. Since I found Jesus down a dead end road, I fell down on my knees, cause it started to tremble. A chill fell over me, it was the Holy Ghost. They all shouted hallelujah, He is delivered. And since you found Jesus, always find hope. I found Jesus down at Dead End Road. I can feel Him with me now wherever I go. A change came over me, it uplifted my soul. Since I found Jesus down at Dead End Road, I found Jesus down at Dead End Road. I can feel Him with me now wherever I go. A change came over me, it uplifted my soul. Since I found Jesus down at Dead End Road, I'm so glad I found Jesus down at Dead End Road.
Thank you, Lonnie, for those good songs. And there's the CD that he just sang the title song from, Dead End Road, and he has a couple of more. And If you'd like to get in touch with Lonnie, call 606-679-8579, and he'll be glad to hear from you. Well, his mom has called and said she really enjoyed hearing her son sing tonight. Now, could you believe that, Lonnie, that your mom enjoyed you?
Yeah, I heard her say that.
And she said that before. Well, she's a real nice lady. She's been over here to sing, too. And so maybe she'll come back before very long and sing for us. And we appreciate her calling tonight. Well, we have, looks like, some more folk to sing for us. These are some of the children that is now part of the King family, and they're all dressed so beautiful tonight and just looking so well. And I believe we're, are they going to sing without him? Okay, all right. The first song they're going to do without their dad. So, all right, let's go over now to this beautiful row of young people.
I'm so glad you came to save us. So glad you came. as the eye could see. Each life somehow touched by your generosity. Little things that you had done, sacrifices made, unnoticed on the earth, in heaven now proclaimed. And I know up in heaven you're not supposed to cry, but I am almost sure there were tears in your eyes as Jesus took your hand and you stood before the Lord. He said, my child, look around you, for great is your reward. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you came. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed. Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am so glad you gave. I am so glad you gave.
Director, he's the one that's fixing to get he's fixing to get married. And do y'all want to come over here and tell him who you are? What's your name, little girl?
Maggie.
Maggie? Okay, you can go that way. What's your?
I'm Mary Grace.
Mary Grace.
I'm Becca.
Becca.
I'm Christian.
Christian.
I'm Jordan.
Jordan.
And I'm Levi.
I recognize you, yeah.
And I'm Jacob.
He's too big to pick up. Was you wanting us to sing another one? Or? Oh, okay. Well, I tell you, it's a pleasure to be over here with Sister Margaret and Don and Bill and Chan and Dottie and all of them. It's kind of like Christmas for the kids. We've got your picture on the refrigerator, and every time I go get a hot dog, I see your. they really think of you all as family, and we appreciate you having us over here. All right, I'm gonna do a song off of my first album. Entitled Hallelujah Highway. The Lord told me it's a long, hard road. It's not always an easy trail. There's danger around every turn that I better watch myself. He said I'd stumble and that I'd fall, but when I called he'd help show me the way so I wouldn't get lost down the Hallelujah Highway. Time goes by like the broken line down the middle of a
need to keep your eyes toward the warning sign. Don't ever lose your faith. There's no black book that you need to take, or there'll be hell to pay if you ever get on this hallelujah highway. There's tolls to pay along the way, and some are paid in blood. Jesus Christ gave up his life, 'cause he believed in us. So when I receive into this mortal life, I know that I can say, my name is in that book of life, there on Judgment Day. And if old St. Peter will let me in, I know I'll hear my Savior say, welcome to the end of his hallelujah highway. Welcome to the end. You did a good job, friend. Welcome to the end of his hallelujah highway.
Thank you. I did a lot of testimonial songs in my albums, and this is one of them. I sort of borrowed the title, but the song is a little bit different. It's entitled, I Surrender It All. I thought I had all the answers. I thought I knew it all. I turned my back on Jesus every time I heard him call. I was living in the moment, thought time would never end. Took a lifetime to realize that he was my greatest friend. Then I surrendered all and put it in God's hands. In no time at all, I became a better man. I was much too weak to stand, way too proud to crawl. Oh, my life was going nowhere, but I surrendered all. Now I have some of the answers I didn't have back then. And I worship my sweet Jesus. I put all my faith in him. These days I'm more careful of where I spend my time. My careless days sinning have all been left behind. I surrendered all, and I put it in God's hand. In no time at all, I became a better man. I was much too weak to stand, way too proud to crawl. Oh, my life was going nowhere, so I
surrendered all. You know my life was going nowhere till I surrendered all.
And that's the truth. My life was going nowhere till I surrender my life to Jesus Christ, and it's the easiest thing in the world to do. All you got to do is just ask the Lord to come into your heart and ask Him to be your personal Savior and confess your sins, and it's a done deal. You know, you'll have a place in heaven from now on. So, you know, you can do it in private. You can do it in church. Amen. All right, this next song is another one of my testimonial songs. It's a little bit peppier. It's one entitled, Since I Let Jesus Take Control. Some men would die for diamonds, and others they crave gold. Some men, if they thought they could get ahead, would sell their brother's souls. They're dancing with the devil, and they're letting Satan lead. You know, I used to be just like them. I was spreading that old demon seed. Then I heard a voice calling. Said, son, you got to change. Doors will start to open when you're knocking in my name. I walk that straight and narrow, headed down Redemption Road. All is well with my soul since I let Jesus take control. Many years I turned my ears away from the holy word. I didn't know I needed to be saved. Suddenly I realized that I was living in disgrace when I heard how Jesus took my place. Then I heard the preacher say, the end is coming soon. You need to change your worldly ways or prepare to meet your doom. He pointed right straight at me and he said, are you ready to go? Always well in my soul since I let Jesus take control. Always well with my soul. So I let Jesus take control. So I let Jesus take control. What are you gonna do? Just let Jesus take control. Let Jesus take control and it'll all be all right. All right. This song here is one that I feel like I'm in kinship with Tom T. Hall on for one reason or another. It sounds like something that he would have written. And it's a story song, and I can't wait to do a video on this song. It's entitled His Church. Just listen to the words and see what you think. You know, she was the daughter
of a good preaching man. She was raised in the church and on the blood of the Lamb. He was a sinner. He never stepped in a church. She prayed for his salvation while he was at work. And he made his living in those old neon lights. A pew was his bar stool, and the band was his choir. He could have won souls for Jesus, but that old devil stepped in. One of God's fallen angels, but she still loved him. And he's never seen her church, and she's never seen him. But they still love each other in spite of this. And she keeps on praying that maybe someday he'll change. But it's been 40 some years now, and he's still the same. Sunday morning, he never came home. You know, she was so lonely there all night all alone. They found him with the Bible turned to Psalms 20. He passed on the glory. He died down on his knees. And he's never seen her church, and she's never seen him. But they still loved each other in spite of this. Some say her praying finally got him released. He passed on to glory. He died down on his knees. One of God's fallen angels just won back his wings.
Thank y'all. All right, thank you for those songs, Alani. And we have your wife and a couple of children up here. You'll have to bring your own chair if you want to join us, and that'll be fine. All right, and her name is Margaret, so I can always remember your name. There's a lot I can't, but the piano bench there is okay if you want it. But anyway, okay, what would you like to share with the people tonight?
Well, as Lonnie has said, we're passionate about adoption since we've adopted 10 children. And I asked Jacob to come up here tonight because he's 18 and he's a Christian. And it's really a blessing to us because he's not ashamed to witness. Mm. In today's world, with all the peer pressure and all the temptations that are out there for the youth, we're just real proud of Jacob because from time to time we find him talking with youth that he's just met, and he's witnessing to them and leading them to Christ. So,
yes.
So we're just real proud of Jacob. Do you want to say something?
Does Jacob
want to
talk?
I just enjoy going to church and being around people that are likable. Like, a lot of these kids out here, just parents don't care. They're running around doing whatever they want. And so I try to hang around the kids that need help, like, that need witnessing. Like, you can't just hang around the people that already know about God. You have to hang around them that don't so you can witness.
Yes. Well, that's very scriptural. Jesus said it's the sick that needs a doctor.
Yeah.
So, all right, that's very good. And now we have a beautiful young lady here. She's going to tell us something. What would you like to tell us? And what's your name first?
Mary Grace.
Mary Grace, and she has something she wants to share with us.
Today is kind of a special day to Mary Grace because this is her 1-year anniversary of being adopted. Oh. She was adopted a year ago today.
Well, great.
I'm just thankful that I've got a family that takes me to church and feeds me and stuff like that. Some children just don't get that. They just, they're just wanting a family. And if you're interested in adopting, just,
what else? There's a lot of children in mm-hmm. Kentucky right now, aren't there? Mm-hmm. Hundreds of children. So if anyone out there, I know there's all different types of families. There could be couples who have never had children. There could be families that, like us, usually have an extra child in their home, one of their children's friends over to eat dinner a lot or just over playing a lot. Maybe it's in the future for you to consider fostering or adoption because, as Mary Grace said, there are a lot of children out there who really need someone.
So what do you enjoy the most about your new home?
I just love everything.
You do? Well, bless your heart. I wish everybody was that nice.
So you enjoy singing too, don't you, Mary Grace?
That's good. All right, that's great. Do you help cook? Mm-hmm. Do you? What do you cook best?
A lot of stuff.
A lot of stuff? Macaroni and cheese?
Help some.
Mm-hmm. All right, well, I think that's the sweetest thing we've heard in a long time. How old are you now?
Nine.
Okay. Mary Grace is 9 years old, and she's talking about how she appreciates a home. I know some kids that do not appreciate even having a home, and here's one that really appreciates it. Well, we're real proud of you, honey, and we're thankful too that you've got a good home and a good mommy and daddy and brothers and sisters that, and all of you can get to go to church and love the Lord together. What's some of your hobbies? What's some of the things you like?
Yeah, I'm singing. Lots of, like, swimming and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. Do you have any
gymnastics
pets?
We have one kitten. Her name is Mittens. A bigger cat. They're both bobtails. His name is Bob. And then a dog, an inside dog. His name is Trey.
All right. You have a lot of animals to feed then, don't you? That is great. Someone's taking your pretty picture. Is that your big sister? What's her name?
Becca.
Becca? All right. She's taking your picture. What else would you like to tell us today?
Can't think of anything else you'd like to say? What about you, Jacob?
No, I'm good.
Okay. Lonnie, what about you? You have something you want to share to that?
Well, like Margaret said a while ago.
Give him your mic.
Well, you can borrow.
You're speaking his.
Margaret said a while ago, we're real proud of all the kids, and Jacob, he's one of those kids that you know, anything you want him to do, he's there for you, and he's there for his family, and we really appreciate him, and all the kids are like that. Mary Grace, you would think her being so little, she wouldn't be that helpful, but she will climb a counter in a second to get to a pot.
Oh, and, yeah, great.
It's the funniest thing you ever saw. But yeah, we just really enjoy them all, and you know, there's just so many kids out there that could use a good home, even if it's temporary. You know, it would help them that much. And you know, shame is there's a lot of them that are like above 10, 18 years old, and it's hard for them to find a home. Mm-hmm. And
how old were you, Jacob?
I was 10.
Yeah, Jacob was 10 years old, and you know, he's just living proof that you know, Jesus was adopted, and Nostradamus, and just all kinds of famous people. Can you think of any right off the top of your head, Margaret?
Faith Hill.
Uh-huh.
Mark Twain.
So, you know, being adopted means that you're loved, you know, and you're wanted. Your natural children, you're stuck with them either way. but you know, it's we're just so blessed to have them around and have them to fellowship with. You know, they're not only our kids, but they're also fellow Christians, and you know, we want to keep them in church and so that they can bring their kids up and break the cycle.
And they're fun.
Yeah,
we have a lot of fun together. There's two things, you know, that are so funny, and we just, you know, we have a very noisy home. We have a lot of laughter. I mean, sometimes the kids do argue, as any siblings will, but basically we just have a lot of fun with them. They love music, and they're always singing around the house, so it's very noisy. Pianos playing, saxophones playing, dogs barking, kids laughing, and when I think back when I was a child and would think about becoming an adult, that's what I wanted. So I'm living my dream with my noisy home.
That's great. Well, I have three adopted grandchildren, and so they're. I know how special they are. We got up at 3 o'clock one morning to go all the way to Newport for the ceremony when two of them was adopted, and I could hardly stay awake. But it was worth it. All right. Well, it's so good to have this family, and the service tonight has really touched the hearts of people. Here's a lady, a name withheld, she has called and asked Jesus to come into her heart tonight. Isn't that good? And also here's another lady from Powell County that has accepted the Lord tonight. And from Betty Joe from Leslie County has called and accepted the Lord. And we have, let's see, some folk that has, Robert Short from Leslie County really enjoyed the singing tonight and said the best he ever heard. I bet it was when you sing, don't you? All right, Barbara from Somerset, she's really enjoyed the singing tonight. And there's Reverend Randy Hawkins for his daughter in Sweetwater, Tennessee, that has bulging disc and she needs healing. And here's another one from Fayette County's in UK hospital in a coma. And someone's had a stroke and she's not ready to meet the Lord. Dorothy's in St. Joe Hospital. Earl's in Central Baptist Hospital. And on the requests go, but we're going to have to pray over these. And I am glad these children are up here. And, you know, they have a lot of faith. And I know that they're going to help pray for these people to all to be healed and to be happy. Right? Mm-hmm. Okay,
Lonnie, can you grab a mic there and lead us in prayer? There's the oil if you want to anoint them, which we usually do, and we will agree, and we'll have Mary Grace and Jacob to help with the prayer. We're about to run out of time, so we'll. All right.
Father, we thank you for all that you do for us, Lord. And we know there's lots of people out there suffering, Lord, that can use your healing touch, Lord. We want to pray over these prayer requests that's sent in tonight, Lord. We want to anoint these prayer requests in your name, Lord. And just wrap your protective shroud around them, Lord. And in Jesus' holy name, we pray. Amen.
All right. Thank you so much. Several has been saved tonight, and a lot of people sick. A lot of people need healing. And so, now, if you're interested in what, let's see, how did you say to get in touch?
They could just call their local Department for Children and Families office. The number's in the phone book. Just whatever county you're living in or whatever state. Just get in touch with your Department for Children and Families, and they'll give you further instructions.
Okay. All right. That is great news, and we'll be praying for more people to find a good home, won't we? Well, she's the sweetest little thing.
Thank you.
Maybe she needs to come live with me. Would you go home with me? She's not even interested. She's got a good home. That's great. All right. Well, we've had some of the grandkids at my house this week, and they've eaten cake and spilled it on the floors and popcorn and just all that things. They thought it would just disappear if they just left it there. Does it do that? No, it doesn't. Well, really sweet children, and the others that did such a great job, and appreciate the sacrifice and the enjoyment that the King family is having with these children. You know, these are God's creation, and they are just as important as any of us, and because they came from God too, and so that's wonderful. They have a good home. But you continue to pray for them, and a lot of folk are not able to take on children, but you can pray and ask the Lord to help others. Well, they're saying we're out of time, so from all of us here, we want to say good night, and God bless you.
Fields are wide to harvest, but the laborer quietly they are coming, loneliness and wounded and cold, hearts hungering, so broken, and they're so